अकाल चैनल नू सब्सक्राइब करो, नवी वीडियोस दी नोटिफिकेशन दे ले बेल आइकन नू क्लिक करना ना भूलना।
Bringing it to you now, Dr. Gurnam Singh, do you feel that there's a lack of fairness in the way media Khalistan, media report on Khalistan, and as somebody yourself that presents on live TV, on TV in general, is this something that you have to kind of weave your way around?
I think there is. I agree with a lot of what Shamshir said in his analysis, but I would add to that, I would say that, you know, why is there fairness? You know, what's the reason behind that? And I think that just to see it as a conspiracy theory, I think is too simplistic. I would say that the media have many things, but if, broadly speaking, if you're looking at the print media and to some extent the television media, and particularly in India, but internationally, there's two kinds of positions that you get. You get pro-Indian government, you know, media, and you know everybody knows that in India, you know, much of the media is bought off. So you get that, and they're probably put, you know, paid to put that line there. Probably happens in other countries as well. You know, if you think about the Daily Mail and things. But there's also what you find: a lot of people who work in the media are liberal liberals, like maybe like me. I don't know, who kind of try to engage in reasonable and rational debate. And I think that one of the problems is I don't think that the Khalistan, those people who are advocating Khalistan, have made a strong enough argument for Khalistan. And that's not an argument against, but it's actually saying that it's such an important struggle that we need to make stronger arguments. And working in the media, where I do bring pro-Khalistanis onto the, sometimes I'm scared to ask them difficult questions. Not because, you know, that I'm against Khalistan, but I feel that they might do a disservice to Khalistan. I'll give you a good example of that, a misrepresentation. I had Simranjit Singh Mann a few months ago, I interviewed him. He's seen as a leading figure of the Khalistan movement. And I said, what is your reasoning for Khalistan? And he said, well, the Hindus have got Hindustan, the Pakistanis have got Khalistan, so we can have, Pakistanis have got Pakistan, so we can have Khalistan. So I said, do you then say that the Hindutva is legitimate, because that's what his argument was? And then he kind of went for me and said, "Buki gal karna." So I think we haven't made the arguments, which is in the left, as I think, vulnerable to some of those critiques. Having said that, clearly, you know, all the odds are stacked against us, and you know, nobody can deny that. There are also other big issues around the kind of imperial legacy. Mark Tully, who's reported on the 1984, talked about Bindranwala as this kind of almost a kind of Bin Laden type of character. So you've even that kind of colonial construct is still there. So you know we are fighting on all corners, but we haven't really put our case across in the way that.
Akal channel nu subscribe karo. Navi videos di notification de layi bell icon nu click karna na bhulna.